going to give you a little more information about how this is made and how it runs. This had 3 feet on the bottom. I changed it to 4. This piece of wood's not real flat, so it rocks a little bit. I'm just going to put a washer under that 1 foot, and that will stabilize that. The displacer that's bouncing back and forth, it's just the end of a glass tube, and it's attached to that piece of brass in the center with 2 silicone O-rings. That metal rod is solid, so the fit of that brass on that shaft is loose enough that the air can escape past it. There's no compression inside that tube created by the displacer going back and forth. And this piece has several holes drilled from this inside diameter to the inside of this outer tube, which is the hot end, so the air can quite easily flow back and forth. For a Ringbom engine like this, or for any Stirling engine, you want a hot end, and then your power piston is the cold end, and you need some good intermediate cooling here. And this cools very well, because when this is running, I can put my finger on here. It's barely warming up, if at all. So I'm going to fire this up this time. I'm going to demonstrate just how fast this thing will go, and I'm going to measure it with a laser tack. Got a piece of reflective tape on the flywheel. That's a good representative range, 200 to 2,200 RPM. When you see this displacer on the camera, it looks like it kind of stutters back and forth a little bit. That's the shutter speed of the camera being out of sync with the movement of the displacer. When I'm looking at it, that is very stable. If you have this running fast and you try to slow it down too quickly, the displacer will get out of sync with the pressure pulses, and sometimes it'll stop momentarily until this slows down enough and then it catches up. the pressure pulses are being created by the power piston, and that's what's making that displacer jump back and forth.